The only slight chance, I think, is in the morning hours. And again, it'll be around the New York City area.
Perfect. The perfect dive, right?
Always. So, beautiful weather to go swimming, huh? The weather's going to cooperate here for about 2 days. Temperatures in the 80s, pretty darn nice. So then we dive into summer by Wednesday, and it's going to stay that way till Friday. Really sticky, really hot, hazy, humid, the works. And as you can see over on the east side here, some scenes, bright sunshine. We're around a Bergdorf Goodman, I believe. Marianne, I wonder if they have any sales, you know?
We'll check it out later.
Yeah, we'll have to. 72 degrees now, relative humidity 47%. The barometer holding steady, and our winds are out of the north now at 9 miles per hour. We're still looking for the winds to shift to out of the south later this afternoon and kick in a sea breeze. That'll keep some of the coastal waves just a tad bit cooler. But we've got clear skies here in town, and we have high pressure sitting directly on top of us now. What that does is, you can take a look at the satellite here, is it keeps the area clear. Sinking air, it hinders the clouds from forming. You can see this high pressure system has clear skies all the way off to the west through the Ohio River Valley all the way up to the Midwest. Some clouds, however, have been gathering just to the south and right around the Central Plains, and this is where most of the action is expected to stay today. Right around the Central Plains, a lot of thunderstorms pulling out of eastern Kansas, right into St. Louis, Missouri, and around Arkansas. A few storms also have been firing up right along the Gulf Coast states today, from Panama City over into New Orleans. And it's in this area, right around the southeast, that we're going to watch a little low-pressure disturbance develop tomorrow. This low pressure system is expected to work its way slowly to the northeast, and with all the three H's coming back into play by the end of the week, the heat, haze, and humidity, it'll be a perfect situation for thunderstorms. And that is really our next chance of rain here on Friday. As for today, brighter conditions, brighter than yesterday, very pleasant across the entire northeast, all the way down to the mid-Atlantic states, temperatures in the 80s. That's normal for this time of year. 84 expected in town around JFK, 84 at Newark, 80 degrees down through Belmar near the Jersey Shore, 82 at Islip. Some cooler temperatures again right along the coast because that sea breeze coming up through the area. Comfortable tonight. Temperatures falling down into the 60s, and you'll notice too some 50s in a lot of the outreaching areas. 59 White Plains up through Bridgeport, about 58 degrees over to the northwestern corner of New Jersey. Here it is, folks, your 4th of July forecast. High pressure now off the coast tomorrow, so that means that we'll have a southerly flow for most of the day tomorrow. Some high clouds kicking back in. It'll be a little hazy, maybe some thunderstorms dancing to the south and west of us, but not here around the metropolitan area. 62, clear and comfy, mostly sunny tomorrow, 86 the high, cooler along the coast. 5 days.
54 in 1933. Let's go up in space and take a shot down. This is from the geostationary satellite in space. As the Earth turns, the satellite stays stationary and it turns with us. It takes a whole bunch of pictures, and of course, we put it together and make a movie loop out of it. And you can see how the clouds moved away. And we have some clouds to our south, but don't worry about them. Tomorrow, another nice day with a high pressure. So, sunshine for tomorrow, yes. The UV index, 9. Very, very high. Make sure you have the sunscreen. You don't want to get wrinkled, and you don't want to get the dangers from the ultraviolet rays. So nice and dry, 50s and 60s overnight. But tomorrow, 80s, the nice and dry weather edges off. The humid conditions start coming in. And then, yeah, the dry air exits by Wednesday, and more humid conditions with a chance of showers coming in later in the week. For the 4th of July tomorrow, beautiful. Riverhead, 80 degrees, mostly sunny skies. Nora, Connecticut, 81. Seabright, New Jersey, nice too, about 79 degrees. Staten Island, nice, 82, and about 83 degrees for you in the Bronx. So very nice 4th of July. If you're going to the beach, 75 to 80 degrees, mostly sunny skies. Again, UV index very high. Winds out of the southeast, 15, 3-foot seas on the ocean, 2 feet on the sound. Water temperature close to 70 degrees, so it's going to get very nice. Cool for tonight in the 50s on Long Island, 50 to 55 north and west, 63 here in town. And then by the time you wake up in the morning, it'll be a nice morning, a nice time to go out in the backyard, have a cup of coffee on the balcony if you want to do that too. If you're in an apartment, 65 degrees. By lunchtime, sunshine again, about 77, 83 degrees in the afternoon for a high right here in the city, I think.
But this just in, the Southampton Town Parks Department has reopened Long Beach.
Oh.
So get your bathing suits ready. That oil spill had the beach closed on Sunday and yesterday, but now it is open for business.
Good.
Business means, of course, whatever you want to do out there. In town, 78 degrees, the temperature, we're warming things up, and we're also heating things up with some humidity. 45%, that's the humidity. That will continue to go up today. The winds are out of the south at 13 miles per hour, and it's because of this southerly wind that we're going to bring some moisture into the area. Well, we've already started. It's at 45%, that relative humidity. It's going to allow some clouds to work into the area, too. So as we take a look at the satellite, I'll show you, we've got them already. A few clouds, high-level clouds. Now, later this afternoon, some mid-level clouds will try and creep in. Some cumulus clouds will try and pop. Those are the summertime-type clouds that we get, the thunderstorm ones, when we've got some moisture pulling into the area and when we start to heat things up. The way it appears now is that, well, some moisture is pulling into western Pennsylvania and right around West Virginia, even Maryland, some thunderstorms are popping. The way it appears now is that some moisture will start to work into the area. Later this afternoon, we may find some thunderstorms rolling around western and central New Jersey, widely scattered. 90% of the area should remain rain-free, but later this evening after the fireworks, one or two may creep into the metropolitan area, but that's about it. Got some clouds gathering, too, across the central portion of the country, and folks, there has been a lot of rain here right around eastern Kansas, Nebraska, into Missouri, and as it appears now, this is the same storm system that will bring us some rain on Friday, but not until Friday. However, today, warm and humid.
Winds from the south at 12, barometer on the rise. This afternoon, it warmed up nicely. The high temperature today, 86 degrees. 64 was the low. No rain. Record 102 in 1949, if you can remember that one, and 55 degrees in 1986. Now, let's go up in space and look down as we usually do at this time every night. And we can see that we have mostly clear skies to start out with. Some clouds then moved into the northeast. We do have a system now that is going to be bothering us over the next several days, mostly with increasing humidity and the chances for showers. We do have showers to the south of the city. You can see on the radar over in Pennsylvania as they move toward us with the sun going down, we didn't have enough instability. By the way, all of this here is not real. This is what we call clutter. They're false radar echoes, so don't pay attention. Long Island, you're not getting anything right now. Just central Jersey, some light stuff. Now, sultry summertime air, say that fast five times, down south will be moving up the comfort zone. We'll see you later. For now, it's going to go away. By tomorrow, we're going to be in the heat. Chances of showers, so get the hairspray ready and bear with it because it won't last too long. A couple of days, maybe 3 or 4 days. We'll see that by Thursday, still warm and humid, we have a trough of low pressure. Don't you hate when that happens? That's an elongated area of low pressure, and that's going to create the instability for some showers and maybe thunderstorms. But look at this. We see cooler air, drier air in the midsection of the country, and that will come visit us a little bit later on. So not too bad. A little bit of humidity and showers, and then it gets better. Now, for tomorrow, like this in Yonkers, about 82 degrees. Our friends in Brooklyn, 85 degrees. Look for a different day, not too much sunshine, too. The UV index for tomorrow, only 5, so not too bad. About 81 up in Stamford, and about 86 at Trenton in New Jersey. Now, at the beaches, 75 to 80, my forecast high temperatures. Slight chance of a shower, excuse me, in the afternoon. Winds from the south at 15 knots, seas 3 feet ocean, 2 feet on the sound, and the water temperature approaching 70 degrees, so that's pretty good. So overnight tonight, becoming humid, maybe some patchy fog, 68, 63 to 67 in the suburbs, and then by the time you wake up in the morning, look for some clouds around 71 degrees by lunchtime. Kind of sticky, kind of humid, about 80 degrees.
Mounts in and around the tri-state area. Let's talk about last month, June. Normal should be 3.67. The actual was 2.09, so below normal, close to an inch and a half. Let's talk about January through June. We're talking about the city. The normal should be 23.59 inches. The actual holding at 15.94. Let's talk about the reservoirs. The normal amount in the reservoirs this time of year, remember what Jack said, winter had very little snow, 95.8%. That's where we should be. We're holding at 84.8%, and again, close to a drought watch. It could go to a warning if we do not get rain, and right now, hit and miss, scattered showers, thunderstorms for the next 36 to 48 hours, 72 hours, but no sustained rain really in this forecast. Very summer-like conditions. So when you take a look at the radar, you can see a lot of showers breaking loose across the Ohio Valley, a lot across portions of Louisiana, Mississippi, Alabama, Georgia, where they had 1 to 4 inches of rain. Here in the Midtown area, we're good till about late tomorrow afternoon, tomorrow night. At that time, as the warm front gets gets closer and closer. Then a cold front pushes in from the west. We could have hit and miss scattered showers, thunderstorms. That would be late tomorrow afternoon and tomorrow night. A better shot on Friday before it tapers off. That would be over the weekend. A lot of boxed areas again across the Ohio Valley, especially over the Southland, will dissipate the rain. Will by figure midnight, that should do it. The watches and warnings gone by about 1 a.m. So for us and the remainder of tonight goes like this, everybody. Warm and muggy, maybe a shower or a thunder shower. Not to worry, these will be hit and miss. 95% of our viewing area tonight is dry, 65 to 70. For tomorrow, a lot of looks. Mother Nature puts on a show. Clouds and hazy sun, then scattered showers, maybe a thunder shower late afternoon.
You know, you're kind of a wild and crazy guy, as you mentioned, so you'll probably be able to handle it. It was a little tough flying to the west today, Tony, though. Look at these thunderstorms that came across Pennsylvania, big ones, but then they hit towards the eastern seaboard and gone. Just a little bit of rain moving up towards Orange County, and actually they need it there, and up towards Dutchess County and Ulster County, because that's the area where the reservoirs feed New York City. So we need to get rain there. Remember, we're under a drought watch. Got a better chance of rain coming tomorrow. Let's check the stats for the day. In New York City, we got up to a high of 83, just slightly below average this time of the year. Low 70, no precip today. 98 the record high, and 54 the record low. And right now in New York, still kind of muggy, 75 degrees. The dew point's rising now. As it gets closer to 70, it gets more uncomfortable. Humidity 79%. Wind out of the south at 16. The barometer is holding steady. All right, satellite picture now. We're going to fly into the northern parts of the Great Lakes area where we find cool air pushing down. And as that does so, it's sort of pushing up the clouds ahead of it. And you can see these clouds here have been producing some wild showers and thunderstorms today all along the eastern seaboard. Get from Pennsylvania right on down into the Carolinas. Kind of like what you would see back in April or May, really not something you'd see in July. And some severe thunderstorms still ongoing tonight in the eastern parts of the Carolinas, but things have quieted down considerably up here. But we'll take our weather flight now through the clouds and get up into the northeast, where we find that line of clouds just to our west and basically trying to advance into the New York City area. And as the nighttime hours have come along, the sunshine has disappeared. That's the fuel for these storms, and basically the things are starting to fall apart. So we're going to be looking at an improvement for the night as we go along. You can watch on the big radar scan here. Everything really is just falling apart. So no rain coming up in the forecast tonight, but a better chance coming into the forecast tomorrow. That's because a cold front will be dragging in from the western states, coming across the Great Lakes, sort of bringing up that warm and humid air ahead of it under southerly winds, and the cooler, drier air that you saw a moment ago in the satellite picture coming in across the Great Lakes area. Even some mild air basically moving in across southern parts of Michigan and Indiana. And the showers and thunderstorms all along that front tonight. Well, again, tomorrow, that system continues to advance on to the east, and as it does so, that threat of thunderstorms mostly later tomorrow afternoon, and it looks like that front will stay maybe close enough to just trigger a shower on Saturday, but improvement is going to be the word by Saturday afternoon, and I think on Sunday real dry air moves in, so not too bad a weekend forecast coming up. And here's my version of our getaway. Deborah, we're looking for, again, just a chance at a shower or thunder shower on Saturday, otherwise some sunshine, 70s and low 80s, and a nice day, drier air, less humid air, with temperatures in the low 80s most places coming up on Sunday. 76 to 85 at the shore tomorrow. Again, look out for a late day thunderstorm with winds out of the south and seas 2 to 3 feet. Overnight, just muggy with lots of clouds. 71 or 2 here in the city and about 65 to 70 in the suburbs. Tomorrow, just like this morning, clouds, some fog, some haze and humidity, 74. Lunchtime, a little sun will pop through, hazy and humid, about 80. Tomorrow's high 84, and look out for big thunderstorms, maybe severe, later tomorrow afternoon. Here's the 5-day forecast. Just the risk of a shower or thunderstorm on Saturday. Otherwise, some sunshine, 83. Drier later in the day. Drier, nice on Sunday.
Outside right now, 74 degrees. We have partly cloudy skies. The relative humidity is 84%. Winds out of the south at 13. And the barometer is holding steady at 3010. The high today at Central Park was 83. Low 70. No precipitation recorded. From our neighborhood weather net at Hewlett High School on Long Island, it is now 70 degrees. But look at your relative humidity at 99%. Fog forming out there, very light winds. Some dangerous driving conditions in some areas tonight due to the dense fog. We do have some light precipitation to show you on radar. Not much at all on NEXRAD 4. This is what's left over of that line of strong storms that pushed through Pennsylvania. Just some scattered light showers. Some of those scooting into sections of New Jersey and to the south as well, but nothing severe at all. Just barely a little bit of rain. Watch that line of storms develop over a 12-hour period. They were quite intense, producing some tornadoes over the southern sections of Pennsylvania, but by the time it got here, the air was a little bit too stable, and the line sort of broke down and diminished quite a bit. But things may get fired up again tomorrow because the system that produced that has not made it through our area just yet. Across the nation, pretty clear across the central sections. There's some strong storms over North Carolina tonight and Texas. The West Coast looks pretty good. Tomorrow's high temperatures, 90 for Washington, D.C. and Miami, looking at 89 degrees in St. Louis, 112 in Phoenix, and 73 in San Francisco. Tomorrow, here across our area, here comes the front, and not ahead of that, we could see some severe storms for us here. Tonight, maybe a few scattered light rain showers, mostly just clouds. Temperatures in the 60s to around 70 degrees. Tomorrow during the day, looking at 80s and a chance for thunderstorms, and some of those may be heavy in the afternoon. Here's your five-day forecast now. As we look ahead and see what we're expecting here, strong storms tomorrow possibly and a few left over on Saturday. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, nice, especially Sunday with a high of 80 degrees and lower humidity after the front moves through. Now it's time to salute the folks who do something.
With
Xander. For years, Renee has volunteered.
29.98, and it is still holding steady. Again, a little more rain showers are coming shortly. I'll show them to you in just a second, but still very steamy across the deep south. These are some thunderstorms that are just east of Florida. Here we come up the eastern seaboard, though, and this is the little tropical depression I showed you last night. Well, it's not so little anymore. It's now Tropical Storm Barry with winds at 50 miles an hour, actually now up to 60 miles an hour. I'm waiting for the new advisory. I haven't seen it yet. It's about 325 miles northwest of Bermuda, but it will not affect the New York City area, at least that's not what I'm thinking, because notice how you see a little clearing trend coming in here from Pennsylvania. That's drier air that will eventually sort of kick Barry out to the east, and thus, if you're traveling maybe up to Nova Scotia, you might have a little problem from Barry later on in the weekend. But for us, we're just going to be dealing with this little front that's been coming through the eastern states and causing that shower and thunderstorm activity that you see as it goes into motion now, all that moisture sort of riding up along the front. You can also now start to see that little northern edge of Barry on the satellite picture. All right, let's check the radar. You can see the showers and thunderstorms that are firing this evening in eastern Pennsylvania. Our earlier rain has moved on to the east, but still this line has to come through, so another round of showers or thunderstorms are possible in the next couple of hours. And there's the front from about Montreal, right west of Philadelphia, and it continues again to move on to the east with the showers and thunderstorms scattered basically all along it. This is, though, what is going to be moving in for the weekend. Eventually, it's high pressure, fair weather, building on down, so we'll kick the showers out here tomorrow. Just a chance of a lingering shower here and there as the mild, dry air moves in, and that mostly, again, will be east of the city. And as we get on into Sunday, you'll basically see that high continue to drift on to the east, and that means nice weather, less humidity on the weekend by Sunday, and it looks like, again, the sunshine will continue as well. Getaway forecast, again, a chance of a shower here or there tomorrow. Not a big chance. It'll be partly sunny skies most places. Upper 70s, low 80s. Better day on Sunday, low humidity, and again, upper 70s and low 80s. Beach forecast tomorrow, 77 to 85. Again, look out for a shower. Winds out of the southwest, seas 2 to 3 feet. Here's my forecast overnight. Some showers, maybe a thunderstorm again, patchy fog, 69 or so here in town, and about 60 north and west. And then tomorrow, our forecast shows a bit of cloud cover in the morning, and then some sunshine will arrive around lunchtime. 70 early in the day, 78 by lunch, and 83 for the high tomorrow, and the less humid air definitely will be around here tomorrow evening. Here's the five-day forecast, and the great day on Sunday with partly sunny weather and less humid, 81. 82 on Monday, and nice 85 on Tuesday, getting humid though, and especially on Wednesday, as we may hit 90. And that's what summer's all about, at least when we get to Wednesday. Joe Moreno will keep you posted on the Tropical Storm Barry over the weekend. Tony?
All right, thanks, Nick. I can live with that Sunday forecast. Here's one of those stories that, where the guy said, oops, I should have thought about this one ahead of time. A Brazilian prisoner got himself into quite a scrape. He was making a break for freedom, trying to crawl through a hole in the wall. Must have underestimated his waist size. He had to call for help to pry him loose. Oops, look at me there.
Ralph, I'll see. I'll see what's going to happen. Let me take a look at the five-day forecast.
Suspense, folks.
Suspense is building.
This
is a nice day. It started out with a nice weekend. Of course, after we had some rain on yesterday, some much-needed rain across the area, that frontal system has passed us now. Let's go outside and take a check of conditions where we have 81 degrees. You're looking at Central Park, and folks are out enjoying the sunshine and warm temperatures. Partly sunny skies, still a few scattered clouds. Winds out of the west at 16 miles per hour, relative humidity 45%. Much lower and a lot more comfortable. The barometer is steady. The high temperature today was up to 86. Probably didn't feel that warm, though, with the lower humidity. Low 70, and we had a quarter of an inch of rain at Central Park, most of that falling last night and early this morning. Now we'll go to our neighborhood weather net now from Yorktown High School in Yorktown Heights, New York, where it's 76 degrees right now, made it up to 84 today. Winds generally out of the southeast right now at 9 miles per hour. Relative humidity there at 55%. We'll go to the maps now, and temperatures across the region are very comfortable in the 70s to low 80s. Mount Vernon at 82 right now, Brentwood at 78, Island Heights, New Jersey at 81 degrees. Clouds, not a whole lot of them. We have breaks here and there. We still have low pressure in the upper atmosphere over southeastern Canada. That may still bring a few clouds in here tonight, but the rain clouds are all gone now, and so we aren't anticipating any more rainy weather until maybe about Monday or Tuesday. Tonight, though, partly cloudy skies and temperatures from the mid-50s mid-60s.
A barbecuing day, beach day, any type of outdoor day. It's going to be gorgeous. The humidity is going to be down. The humidity was a little high today, but that didn't stop a couple of folks from getting out to the Greenwich Village Festival down on Bleecker Street. So if you missed it today, you'll be able to catch it tomorrow and even next weekend, because it's going to still be going on. And going on in town now, 83 degrees, the temperature going down, the relative humidity 41%, the barometer is holding steady, and it's a little breezy out there. Look at this. The winds are at 17 miles per hour, but gusting up to 26 miles per hour. Breezy tonight and a bit breezy tomorrow. But hey, who's complaining? It's going to be nice. 86 degrees, the high temperature today. Tomorrow, we'll get close to that. And something else that's been real close to this area is a tropical storm. The clouds over the last couple of hours, we've looped them for you. The tropical storm right here, just off the coast, but it is moving to the northeast. This is Tropical Storm Barry that developed sometime yesterday. It's going to the northeast at about 20 miles per hour. It's not going to influence this area, and we got rid of yesterday's storm system as well. Tonight, we've got high pressure building in. You can see skies are clear from about New York down to Virginia. We're going to hold on to some clear conditions for the overnight hours and for a lot of the day tomorrow. But the story kind of changes tomorrow night. More clouds are building over the Midwest, and this area of disturbed weather is going to bring us a few showers, some spotty showers sometime late tomorrow night and even during the day on Monday. As I step to the side here, you can see another area of high pressure over the Four Corners area. This high pressure system, different than many others, we call it a ring of fire, a ring because there's a ring of thunderstorms around the high building into the northwest, and there are some awfully warm temperatures. Take a look at the temperatures that we'll see across the west tomorrow. 90 degree heat building into the northern plains around that high pressure system. And yes, it's going to start working toward the east. 90 degree heat expected here on Thursday. But a couple of days of 80 degree temperatures because we'll cool off behind the storm system that's real close to the area tomorrow. Again, not any showers until Monday. 64 tonight, a little cooler than what we've seen over the last few, 60 to 65 degrees, and some 50s over the northwest corner of New Jersey. Here it is, folks, what I promised you, abundant sunshine, humidity is going to be low. The best day out of this weekend. Enjoy. 58 degrees, an evening breeze, clearing skies, just gorgeous out there. 58, moving up to 80 degrees tomorrow, mostly sunny, less humid, and tomorrow night, 66, with a few clouds working in. So we've posted those showers during the day on Monday. We may even see a few Tuesday, but we'll hang on to 80 degree temperatures. And then
St. Patty's Cathedral right here, 69 degrees, humidity lower. Look at that, 57%. The dew point temperature dropping as well, and you feel the comfort level, 53 degrees is that. The winds are from the northwest, nice direction, at 17 miles an hour, barometer is on the rise. The high temperature this afternoon was a little bit sticky, a little bit humid, 86 degrees, low this morning, 70. Now, we did get a quarter of inch of rain, and that is good because we continue with that drought watch right now. But luckily, we got some rain, and hopefully we'll get some more a little bit later on. Record high 100. It happened in 1993, and 56 degrees way, way back in 1894. Now, let's take a look at the clouds, and we'll show you where they're going. They're going out in the ocean, and that's good for us. If you have the day off tomorrow, it's going to be just great around here. We have a northwesterly flow. This is the weather that if you can pay to get it, you would probably do that, but it's free right here at Fox 5. Plenty of sunshine, too. Beautiful all over New Jersey, Connecticut, our friends in Nassau and Suffolk County. You can have a great day tomorrow. Not hot along the coast, just temperatures in the upper 70s. Now, showers and thunderstorms, we continue to see them go away. Springfield, Massachusetts, the last to see the showers. They had strong winds downing some trees just to the west of there, but air to enjoy. These are the key words for tonight and tomorrow. Beautiful in the 60s for tonight. Tomorrow, we see the 80s. Plenty of sunshine, just ideal. Get out the camera. Tomorrow is one of those days. You're going to just enjoy it. You're going to love it. It's not going to last forever, though. It's going to be changing. It's summer now, and we have hot air to the south. In fact, we have a trough. What a trough basically is, it's an elongated area of low pressure. That will tend to creep on by, let's say, late Monday into Tuesday with just a slight chance right now. I think showers may develop. It doesn't look like a big deal at all, but the major thing that I'm keeping an eye on is hot and humid air to the south, and we think later on, the computer models as well, that that air will probably get here, and then we'll say, gee, it's the dog days of summer, and that'll probably happen, I think, Thursday into Friday, so enjoy it now, and then we'll talk about the 90s a little bit later on. For tomorrow, just gorgeous. Jones Beach, 78 degrees. Shirley on Long Island, 80. Greenwich, Connecticut, 81 degrees. And our friends in Queens, 83 degrees, all with mostly sunny skies. remember that we will see the UV index creeping up there, so you need to wear your sunscreen if you're going to be out the beach. Now, the forecast for the beach, a little bit cooler if you're going to be on a boat on the ocean. 73 to 77 degrees is my forecast high. Winds from the northwest and then switching to the west at about 10 to 15 knots. Now, if you're going to be out there on your boat, 2 feet on the ocean, 1 foot on the sound, the water temperature, look at that, creeping up there, 67 to 73 degrees. So the water temperature getting warmer and warmer as we progress and more into summer. The ocean has a chance to heat up. Now, the UV index, again, from the sun to the earth, the ultraviolet index, it is not a good thing. It is bad for you. It does good, of course, but the bad things, it causes wrinkle, it causes aging, and yes, it causes cancer. But we like to stay on the beach and enjoy it. Do it wisely. Wear the sunscreen. You could stay there as long as you have it on. Forecast for tonight, much drier, 64 degrees, 55 to 60, north and west of New York City, Nassau and Suffolk County. You may even want to take out a blanket. It's going to be crisp and dry, untypical for July, but enjoy it. And then by the time you wake up in the morning, it'll be nice and sunny. 68 degrees by lunchtime, sunny as well, about 80, 83 for an afternoon high. And then by the time you drive home for wherever you're going to be going tomorrow afternoon, 81 degrees, plenty of sunshine too. And the next several days around here, we see Monday and Tuesday is when we have that slight chance, and I accent that slight chance of showers late Monday into Tuesday, with daytime highs gradually creeping up. There's a slight chance for showers and thunderstorms, and then by Wednesday and Thursday, that hot, muggy, summertime July air pays the New York City area a visit with temperatures in the 90s. By Thursday, and I think again by Friday. So enjoy what we have right now, because it ain't gonna last. Back to you guys.
Well, 3 years ago, the Puma Corporation started street soccer in Europe's urban areas. Now it's in New York. Puma USA also held a tournament up in East Harlem. They want to give inner city kids a chance to get off the street. Teams are made up of boys and girls between the ages of 10 and 16. Some supermodels like Jennifer Flavin, Tyra Banks, Jill Goodacre teamed up to net some profits for a good cause at an East Hampton fundraiser.
It's been mostly sunny today. We've had clouds in and out, and you saw a swirl over the Canadian Maritimes. That's what was left of Tropical Storm Barry. It's moving away and out to sea, producing some gusty winds, but
plunging a lot in the water, huh?
Oh,
it's going to get hot.
Yeah, let's just say we'll have temperatures that'll be reading three-digit degrees. This forecast to build this way. We're looking at a winter cam shot here of George Washington Bridge. You can see we've got some mostly sunny skies, but it did take a while to get here. The clouds, some of them have finally moved out. The clouds we had earlier today kept temperatures down in the 70s, and the number that's just to the other side of that, well, that's the normal temperature. So you can see that we were running about 10 degrees cooler than norm, 74 degrees in Kingston today, 72 in Central Park. Kind of ironic that it was so cool in Central Park, because today was the anniversary of the warmest number ever recorded for Central Park, which was 106 degrees set in 1936. 77 Atlantic City, 70 degrees Trenton. Once again, we've got some sunshine now, so these numbers may warm just about another number or two before it's all over with. 72 now, relative humidity 51%, the barometer falling, and we've got winds that are out of the west at 10 miles per hour. Thank goodness for the westerly winds, because at least it helped to break up some of the clouds. But as you take a look at the satellite now, some clouds have rolled on out of here. A little weak disturbance earlier today provided those, but more clouds are moving in. Yet another weak disturbance forecast to move this way as it approaches the area. We may see about 2 to 3, maybe even 4 hours of some mostly clear to partly cloudy skies, but turning over to mostly cloudy skies during most of the overnight period. This disturbance a bit stronger than the one that we had today, so we may even see some showers, perhaps a thunderstorm, dancing around the area late tomorrow afternoon. But all in all, high pressure will keep us mainly dry, and you'll notice on the other side of the system another area of high pressure. So once it moves in sometime on Tuesday, we'll see temperatures in the 80s, but then after that, forget it. We'll have some heat building in from the southwest, and temperatures will be in the 90s, close to 100 degrees Friday, Saturday, Sunday, definitely next weekend. 62 tonight. Numbers will be about where they were last night. It's the kind of weather where you can turn the air conditioner off, or just great sleeping weather. Mostly cloudy, cool and breezy tonight. Tomorrow it's back into the 80s, so we'll warm up about 10 degrees or so from where we were today. Maybe some thunder showers tomorrow afternoon, more thunder showers right into the overnight period. 66, the overnight low. AccuWeather says get ready for the heat. It hits us toward the end of the week, 92 expected Thursday. That heat comes with a lot of haze and a lot of humidity, so enjoy the next couple of days and forget about those showers. They're not going to be a lot. tomorrow.
We have a couple of days of a respite before that. We want to talk about Giglio Sunday at the Shrine of Our Lady of Mount Carmel on Habermeyer Street in Brooklyn. This is an 85-foot, 4-ton statue that commemorates the return of St. Paulinus from captivity in the 4th century, and it's an annual festival. And the day for it in Brooklyn was, as you can see, very graphically, absolutely beautiful. Music and lilies. Giglio means lily, celebrating that particular feast. And let's talk temperatures around your neighborhood of mine. 72 in Midtown, 72 in Beechhurst. It's temperatures in the 70s around our area, sub-60s, a west wind at 10 miles an hour, 51% relative humidity. That's awfully nice, isn't it? Here we go. We go to Earthwatch. We're seeing some radar enhancement. A few showers are scattered around. Yes, down south, very hot. Later on in the week, it will work its way, this heat and humidity, into your neighborhood and mine. Cool, but cloudy in our area today. Generally, we had variable clouds, some sunshine, but it was awfully spiffy. Here's the deal. High pressure is dominating our weather, and it's a little bit to the east of our area. The heat at the moment is being kept down to the south. That, though, will change. Yep. Come tomorrow, the heat will work a little closer. A villainous low is going to push clouds into your area and mine, and they will conspire to rain upon us tomorrow night into Tuesday, and that will also allow this heat, allow this humidity to work into our area, so that come Tuesday, we're going to be at the beginning of a who-knows-how-long heat wave. I mean, it extends through our five-day forecast period. Forecast for tonight calls for this. We're going to have some clouds, and then tomorrow, the clouds will get even more earnest.
In collagen, right?
Well, the afternoon is going to be nice for a while. I think we'll see some pretty good weather today and tomorrow. And then we're going to see this heat wave that is out west just barrel right on in here. And I mean noticeable heat. Here's how things have looked from our roof cam across Central Park. That's, of course, Sheep's Meadow as we look over to the east side. You can see a little bit of haze as we look at this live picture. But it's not really that bad outside. Humidity's in the 50% range. This hour, we do have skies that are sunny. The clouds we had from the morning now have broken up and pushed on out into the Atlantic. Temperature 75, humidity in the moderate range. The barometer has been falling just a little bit. A cold front is approaching from the west. So ahead of a cold front, we have a southerly wind. It was just 2 years ago we got up to 102 on this day. Other temperatures around the area, 79 from LaGuardia to Islip, a little cooler out of the Twin Forks. The wind in the last hour had been out of the northwest around Danbury, so it's 74 there. And down the Jersey Shore, you see, it is 75. Here's our current satellite picture. Here's what's going on at noon. The clouds we had this morning, and there were a few sprinkles from Philly and Maryland to around central Jersey. Those have pushed out into the Atlantic now. And a little bitty, this is a very weak ridge of high pressure is building in behind a cold front that is moving across the western portion of the state. All of this mixed area of weather, the showers, a few thunderstorms that were around yesterday, have now pushed out into the Atlantic. We just have what's called an upper level trough across the area, and we're watching that develop and move on out of the way. And the real hot weather is from the Dakotas across the Central Plains down to the southwest in Texas. There's a little couple of disturbances that are moving along in the mix here across Iowa. Some scattered showers have been right around Chicago. And off to the west, there have been a few sprinkles in the northwest where some cooler air has been coming in. But the real focus of the weather over the next few days will be the real unbearable heat that is across Texas, the Central Plains, and into the Great Lakes. There are a few scattered showers, like I showed you, poised off the coast, continuing into the Atlantic. Really not a lot of showers to create a lot of relief from this hot weather. This quadruple play of high pressure will keep coming our way and gets here on Wednesday. Here's our AccuWeather forecast map for this afternoon. A mix of clouds and sun. Might be a late sprinkle with the passage of that cold front later this afternoon, but it's not likely that you'll see any showers at all this afternoon, maybe a few clouds for tonight. Temperatures this afternoon into the low 80s in the city, 81 in northern Jersey. The coastal sections will be just a tad cooler with that southerly wind. Tonight, temperatures in the mid-60s in the city, cooling off pretty good north and west. Tomorrow, another warm day, 84, but that hot air is poised off to the west tomorrow, and that is going to get here and make things really hot. That heat wave will hang around for about 4 to 5 days. Here's your AccuWeather forecast for tonight. It'll be a mild night. A few clouds around, mostly cloudy skies, 66. Tomorrow, clouds and sun, maybe a scattered thunderstorm tomorrow afternoon, but it's the summertime. You know, one of those can pop up in some spots.
And welcome back, Bill. As we walk to the wall, well, we'll tell you that the heat does come on, and we're going to show you some warm temperatures by the end of the week. More than warm. It's going to be hot by the end of the week. But it's 80 degrees outside right now, relative humidity at 50%, and the barometer is falling. We have a weak impulse that's going to move through the skies and give us the opportunity of getting one or two scattered thundershowers tonight. We'll have the same possibility tomorrow night, and then that's it for rain for the week. So it's going to be dry and hot by the end of the week. So South winds at 17 miles per hour. 102 would have been a record. Most of us just above the 80-degree mark. But look at where we'll be, just above the 90 and very near the 100-degree mark by the end of the week. Thursday, the heat really comes on. 92 degrees, 85 is normal by Friday, 98 degrees in town, which means northern New Jersey and central New Jersey could be very near the 100-degree mark, if not above it by that time, and that lingers on into Saturday, as just a sneak preview. Take a look at the satellite picture. We'll show you what's on out there. There are some clouds back off to the west, and NEXTRET Precision Radar has found one or two of exactly what we're talking about. Tonight and tomorrow at night, at this about the same time, evening even, some of these widely scattered, just pinpoint thunderstorms will pick up on the radar screen, drop a little moisture up to a half an inch in some locations, then move on out of the way. That's our best opportunity of getting some moisture in here, and it's not for everybody. Just one or two communities will see them in the afternoon, so there will be one or two scattered around tonight and tomorrow night, and then the heat comes on. It's been record-setting heat into the Central Plains State, a big heat wave for them, and as this high moves east, it's going to bring the heat with it. Again, clock it by Wednesday into Thursday that we start seeing those temperatures go through the roof. It is summer. 68 degrees, patchy clouds out there. AccuWeather says by tomorrow, 84 degrees, sun and clouds, be a spot.
That day at all, don't need the coat, especially the raincoat. Here's what's going on this hour. Sunshine, 77. Humidity drying out, 69%. The barometer has been rising. Winds continue to be mostly out of the east now, and that's kind of keeping a few clouds near shore. Just about a half inch of rain in the park overnight. Other temperatures, 74 in northern Jersey, 77 at Newark, 74 down the Jersey Shore, and it's 74 at Danbury. Here's our current satellite picture. We put the fronts and the systems on here for you. And the thunderstorms that we had have now moved off the shore, and they're out into the Atlantic at this hour. And around Boston and around the Newport News are getting some good scattered showers there. This is the NEXTRAD Precision Radar showing how much rainfall we have. This yellow shade is 2.5 inches of rain. The green shade is about an inch to 2 inches of rain. The shades of blue is a half inch of rain to 3/4 inch of rain across the area. When you get a close-up look, that 2.5 inch area, look there, right around Pelham. There's some scattered showers and some thunderstorms there that produce right around Alpine, Pelham, northern Manhattan, right into the Bronx. 2.5 inches of rain in that system overnight across the rest of the country. High pressure is built in from the Great Lakes to the Gulf Coast. It's a big, hot, high-pressure system. This is the system that will affect our weather after tomorrow. We've got a little high pressure sinking in today. Big ridge of high pressure is sinking in for tomorrow and really across the rest of the country. It's really nice, but it is really hot all the way into the southwest, cool into the northwest across the country. Steaming hot weather across the central plains. Some thunderstorms have been building up over southern Florida. Here is our AccuWeather forecast for this afternoon. Mixed skies, cold front is going to approach. The area has seen those thunderstorms. There might be a scattered one this afternoon, but most likely we're going to just see that front plow on through now with the good sunshine through the afternoon hours and clearing for tonight. Highs this afternoon into the low to the mid-80s in most areas. And tomorrow is going to shape up to be a good day. The hot surge will start tomorrow, however. We'll be around 86. But here's the hot air that's coming our way from the Ohio Valley for Thursday. Clear, comfy tonight, we call it, 68. Tomorrow, sunny and warm, 86.
Right now, things have calmed down, and they should stay that way. Let's look outside. 72 degrees, partly cloudy skies at Central Park. Our winds are coming out of the south at 9. Relative humidity, 78%. A steady barometer. Our high for the day, 84, low 64. 46/100th of an inch of rain at Central Park. Some areas as much as an inch and a half. Unfortunately, our reservoirs only picked up 0.07 of an inch of rain last night. Reservoirs still well below normal. Normally at 94%. Today at 82%. And so the drought watch for New York City and Westchester continues. No mandatory rationing or water restrictions, but we do all need to conserve. As you see, NEXTRAD 4, here come those heavy showers and thunderstorms moving through the area this evening, but right now things have cleared out. What we're watching though now for is a big heat wave coming. The jet stream, the band of air 20,000 feet above the Earth's surface. You can see it's well up to the north, so hot air moves its way in here for tomorrow. Temperatures in the upper 80s, although shoreline areas will see temperatures only in the low to mid 80s, but by the weekend, this big area of high pressure moves to the east. That funnels in very hot air. Temperatures in the 90s. The heat and humidity levels will rise as well. So it is going to be a scorcher heading into the weekend. Not good news for the drought. For tonight, the showers and thunderstorms end. Mid to upper 50s north and west. Mid to lower 60s along the coast. Upper 60s here in town. Out the door tomorrow morning, sunshine. Temperatures in the low to mid 70s. Your boat and beach forecast looking this way. Lots of sunshine. Northwesterly winds 10 to 15 knots. Water temperature 64 to 70 degrees. And your 5 days ahead for you. Here they come, the three H's, hazy, hot, and humid. with a chance of afternoon showers or thunderstorms, upper 80s tomorrow. Then right into the weekend, temperatures in the low to mid-90s. It looks like it is going to be a hot one. Time now to salute the folks in our tri-state area who do.
It's moving some strong gusty winds, even some reports of hail. Scotch Plains near Edison, just one of the towns that reported. Also near Newburgh, we had a lot of places reporting gusty winds, hail, a lot of frequent lightning, and even some heavy rain. Outside right now, skies are beginning to break up and clear. I would look for some fog in the areas early in the morning that received the rain tonight. 71 degrees outside, relative humidity at 78%. The barometer's rising at this point. High pressure sweeps in now, clears out our skies tomorrow, allows plenty of sunshine, but will also bring another side effect. We'll talk about that in a minute. South winds at 8 miles per hour, 84 degrees, the warmest number of the day today, 64 degrees, where we started earlier this morning. Other numbers at this hour include Newark at about 72 degrees and 68 degrees out toward the end of the island. Here's that second side effect that comes with the high pressure and the clearer skies. We're talking about some heat coming up. Can we get one more in there? Because we got, can we go back, Eddie? Is that possible? Thank you. I appreciate that. Hot records that we could bust by Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. We're talking about 100 degrees to 98 degrees, even toward 99 degrees. All these are possible to go down as this heat comes roaring in for the end of the week. Now, how about that satellite picture? There's plenty of clouds that are offshore right now. And just one or two pockets that are holding off the Jersey shoreline. All of this in response to moving these clouds and even those gusty thunderstorms that built this afternoon straight off the shoreline, allowing for these clear skies to get in there. High pressure again, going to be working for us over the next couple of hours. Early morning temperature will be about 66 degrees is what we're looking at. About 62, 64 out toward the end of the island. Inland numbers anywhere from 57 to 60 degrees. Sunrise, by the way, hits at 5:35 in the morning. It does look like we will have some patchy fog just about anywhere you saw those thunder showers tonight. There'll be enough moisture in the air and in the ground to build up a little bit of fog early in the morning. That should last till about 7 or 8 o'clock in the morning. For other places, it'll start sunny and stay sunny tomorrow.
Portion 20 states got into the triple digits today. And let's get right to it, everybody, because the bottom line is the heat is on. Numbers Midtown, and that's Bill Mueller with the shot. You're looking at a flower pot. That's what it is, yes. And also you can see hazy skies and 73, humidity 90%. The winds are southerly today. Today's high 83, normal 84. Today's low in at 68. Well-advertised heat wave just about ready to take shape in and around the tri-state area. So why don't we get to it? And it goes like this. Thursday, the expected high should be right around 90 degrees. The record is 101. Friday, the expected high 97. The record 100. Saturday, 97. This is the forecasted high. Again, the record is 99. Sunday will cool down just a tad. The backbone of this heat wave, the heart of it, the guts of it, will be Friday and Saturday. By Sunday, late Monday, the heat wave will be history. All right, on the radar, you'll be able to see a lot of scattered showers across the southeast, but it's this area of concern. This is high pressure, and around the high, you can get some thunderstorm activities, and also across the southeast. Let's build the map. On the satellite, you'll be able to see the clear skies. You can check it out right here. From border to border, really, you can see high pressure just dominating. The sun is really baking away. Numbers from the 90s to 105 in portions of Kansas to portions of South Dakota. The cold front doesn't make it. The high stays off the middle Atlantic states, and right across that, the southwesterlies will flow, and bang, temperatures will rise. Now watch this map, and once again, the 90s are coming closer and closer on the temperature map, filtering through Pennsylvania. We'll make a run at it west of the city tomorrow. We're into the soup, sauna-like, furnace-like around here, and that'll be the deal Friday and again on Saturday. Tropical wave, top winds 35, movement west northwest 15 to 20, location 300 miles east of Puerto Rico. And this storm is going to miss the island, and they need the rain. Looks like it's headed over the open seas of the ocean. The buck moon, full moon, clear skies, city 65 to 70, north and west 60 to 65. For tomorrow, temperatures right around 90 degrees, more humid and sticky and hazy. Watch the 5-day. You guys got to smile now. No complaints allowed. It's 90 on Thursday. It is 97 on Friday. Need the rain. Hit and miss thunderstorms Saturday. We cool it down Sunday, late and Monday.
This year, first time in, well, a couple of years. So look at the numbers. I've got a 101 on Friday. I've got a hazy and just kind of outside. Southerly winds at 9, relative humidity 90%. A steady barometer, high for the day. 83 degrees, the low 68, and we've had no precipitation. And that lack of precip is why we're in big trouble as far as our reservoirs are concerned. A drought watch in effect for New York City and Westchester. Normally, 98% full should be our reservoirs, but already they're down to 82%, and they continue to drop. And as we take a look at the satellite picture, you can see clear skies on top of us. We've got a weak front that's pushing through, a little trough of low pressure. High pressure then will take over, and this high pressure area sizzling hot in the midsection. section of the country. The jet stream well up to our north, and so that allows the hazy, hot, humid air to work its way in here. So tonight, temperatures only falling back into the 60s and low 70s. Tomorrow, that high will start to work its way to the east. By the weekend, we are talking really hot. You can see tomorrow that we've got temperatures well up into the 90s and 100s in the midsection of the country. And by Saturday, that high has moved to the east. It's going to be very hot, very humid, and with the clockwise flow of air around that high, that's bringing moisture up from the Gulf. We're also keeping an eye on a tropical disturbance that's out in the Atlantic around the Bahamas. That'll bear watching as well. But right now, the big story, the heat, with temperatures by Saturday getting close to 100 degrees. Our forecast for tonight, overnight lows low to mid 60s to upper 60s. Hazy, foggy tonight with partly cloudy skies. Tomorrow morning, it's going to be a rough start to the day as far as the heat and humidity. Temperatures by morning already into the low to upper 70s with fog burning off quickly. Then during the day tomorrow, your boat and beach forecast, the winds out of the south 10 to 15 knots, water temperature 65 to 72 degrees, and here it comes, the three H's, hazy, hot, and humid, right through the period.
I can't believe this is classic already. This just doesn't make sense to me, but yeah, they were out there doing the hustle. Of course, part of Lincoln Center's festivities that go on all summer long. Well, that's pretty good. That's not bad at all. What do you call that anyway when they do that? I can't think of the name of that. 72 degrees outside right now, relative humidity at 90%. There probably wasn't ever a name for that. The barometer's rising at this point, except for foolish weather, man. South at about 6 miles per hour, 83 degrees, the warmest number of the day, 58 degrees where we started earlier this morning. Again, currently you're at 72 degrees and it's pretty warm and sticky out there. Other numbers around the area include 73 at LaGuardia Airport, 67 out toward the end of the island. Tomorrow the same thing will happen. It'll be cooler along the shoreline than it actually is in town. We'll run that way for a couple of nights now. We will also tell you water temperatures in case you're making your plans. We'll drop a bit over the weekend only because with a southwestern wind, we'll be bringing some of the cooler water up to the surface and putting it up against the shoreline. So temperatures will drop 1 or 2 degrees by the time you get out this weekend. That means New Jersey shoreline will be about 72 degrees for water temperature. Also, we were talking about the records of the next couple of days and the ones that would possibly go down with this heat wave. Right now, it looks like only Friday and Saturday are possibly broken. Backdoor cold front looks like it's going to come through and help us cool down a bit for Sunday and put some more clouds in the picture by Sunday afternoon. That's the way it's looking at this point, but let's check the sky. Satellite picture will show you there are some high clouds in the region, though we have a full moon out there tonight. In some areas, it's difficult to see it because of those high cirrus clouds. Yeah, I know. The way I was moving this, it's probably a full moon, right? Though we have a few high clouds out there, we think they'll move out of the way by early in the morning, only to be replaced with some fog, we think, and know that it's going to be pretty steamy all day long tomorrow. That humidity level will just creep up over the next couple of days as that high just places itself right off the shoreline and continues to pump warm air in here. 70 degrees is your early morning low temperature, and that's not cool at all. 63 out toward the end of the island, 63 to 67 degrees northern corner, 62 as you start to work up the Hudson River Valley, and 90 degrees is likely tomorrow, though if the wind stayed to the south, you'll find us a few degrees below that at 88 for the high.
New Jersey, in South Brunswick, a big softball game. The Eyewitness News softball team going to be there. We're going to play for a group called the Citizens for Independent Living. They help disabled adults get into the mainstream, get jobs, and get rehabilitation. Going to be raising money, 1 o'clock, South Brunswick at the park there. I believe the park is called Woodlock Park Recreation Center. Want to help them and raise a lot of money for them.
Good. You do a good job.
Please come because it's going to be so hot. You're not going to enjoy the weather. You'll enjoy the game, however.
You're going to have the seventh inning hose down.
That's right. It's been a hazy, warm, humid morning. And here's how the ferry looked this morning, cutting across from Staten Island. It's been hazy. Look at all that haze around New York Harbor this morning. Flagged straight out this morning when the winds are out of the southwest at about 10 to 15 miles per hour. Here's what we have this hour. We have skies that are sunny. It is humid, 66%. Doesn't seem all that high, but when you put it with an 84 degree temperature, the heat index is at 92 already. Barometer has been falling a little bit, but it's above 30. The winds are southwest. It's a dry, warm wind, and here's the record high and record low for the day. We're not in any danger of breaking that record high for today, but tomorrow and Saturday we will. It's already 88 at LaGuardia, 80 degrees at Islip, 79 degrees out of the Twin Forks. So you see where that southwest wind is blowing across. That's where the higher numbers are. Danbury and at Newark and LaGuardia, coastal sections are going to be the best places to be for today. Here's why. Here's our current satellite picture. And what do you see? Not much. High pressure ridge is across the area, and it's a big hot dome of high pressure. This area of cloudiness is just a little bitty upper trough that passed through, created a few sprinkles this morning as it came across the lakes in the western portion of the state. Nothing else really has been going on. There is a cold front here, however, that might get here by Sunday. I'll tell you more about that in the five-day outlook. There were some showers that were coming in across central Pennsylvania, but those have dried out, and that big ridge of high pressure has worked all the way across now from the central plains to the east coast. There have been some thunderstorms in the Great Lakes, and there is a thunderstorm watch area now for the upper peninsula of in the Great Lakes and the upper peninsula of Michigan. But that's normal for this type of system. All the thunderstorms are revolving.
The barometer is.
And we called.
Check out the satellite picture with me now. You're going to see as we hit the button here, we have a tropical depression that's been sort of right near Puerto Rico, about 175 miles northeast of Puerto Rico. May become a tropical storm by tomorrow, but for the most part, it really hasn't been strengthening. We'll be keeping an eye on it for you, of course. As we take our weather flight now, we're going to start from there and continue across the thunderstorms in Florida, the thunderstorms in the Gulf, and there's that 100-degree heat once again across Texas, Oklahoma, and Kansas. They are in the 110-degree range again in some places. That's the heat that's coming our way. We'll continue on our weather flight and show you that, again, that heat spreads across Chicago, was 100 today. Thunderstorms and some big ones there in Michigan spreading towards western New York. They're not coming our way, but the heat is. As you look at our weather map tonight, too, you're going to find the reason for it. It's a big area of high pressure that's been sitting east of the Carolinas, and the airflow around that high pressure basically out of the southwest. So it comes up from Arkansas and Tennessee right into the northeast. And again, you saw just a moment ago that that's where the 100-degree temperatures are. So the heat is on, and you see in the next 2 days, we'll be in that hazy, hot, and humid weather. Notice that little front that's dropped down from Canada by Saturday. That's going to get real close to us, so we'll stand a better chance of some thunderstorms to move into the area on Saturday. But again, the heat is still going to be the story. If you're getting away to the mountains, 80s to near 90, look out for afternoon thunderstorms Saturday, near 90 at the shore. And again, it could be even hotter than that with not much of a sea breeze. And then we'll look for temperatures basically in the same range on Sunday. Hazy and muggy tonight, areas of fog. It'll get to 75 in town, maybe some upper 60s north and west. But again, a muggy night for the tri-state area. Tomorrow, hazy sunshine when you wake up, about 77. Hazy sunshine will continue at lunchtime as we climb to 90 at lunchtime, and the high temperature for tomorrow at 98 degrees. And it looks like the heat continues tomorrow evening as well. Let's go on and check the five-day forecast. No relief. In fact, we may have a record here on Saturday, folks. If it gets to 100, that'll break the old record of 98. Look at the morning low, only 80. Humid with an afternoon thunderstorm, 93. Better chance of thunderstorm Sunday, and Monday will cool back into the 80s. Tuesday in the mid to upper 80s. So heat wave 1995 is in effect, and I'm going to enjoy my Diet Coke here on the west side. Back to you, Tony.
All right, Nick. Buy those guys a Diet Soda, too, and I'll pay for it.
Yes, you got it.
All right, thanks. We are all thinking about ways to beat this heat. You see that 100 on Saturday? So every Thursday night throughout the summer, we'll be giving you ideas on weekend getaways. And tonight, what better way to chill out than on the water? Linda Schmidt traveled to the Delaware Water Gap for a wild river ride.
It's numbers for the remainder of tonight. AC clicks on. If you're fortunate enough to have it, a hit and miss thundershower, mid-70s. That's it. A matter of fact, we may get it going right around 80 degrees tomorrow morning, north and west 65 to 70 for tomorrow. Nice and easy does it. 93 to 98, the record is 100 degrees. Watch the five-day and you'll see the triple digits for the first time in a long time. We're forecasting, where, me, for the next one. I sound like I have a staff here. Anyhow, it's right around 100 degrees. That'll be the deal. Water temperatures right around 60 to 64. That's good. Thunderstorms come by Sunday late, and hopefully the heat wave will end by Sunday late. Monday temperatures will be in the upper 80s. But for sure, the next 48 to 72 hours will be very, very difficult around here. A lot of water, close to the water if you can, close to the AC if you can.
Yeah, take it easy. Thanks, G. Let's hope they're not teasing us, but it looks like the Yankees might
better
be
better. Scattered thunderstorms over the weekend in Jersey City. Greg Bonaccio, happy birthday to you tonight.
Thank you very much. Let's move on. I wish we could say that. Outside at this hour, oh, it is awfully close out there. 82 degrees and hazy skies. Makes you feel like you're in Haiti. Our winds are out of the southwest at 7, relative humidity 67%, a barometer on the rise. High for the day 92, low 71, no precipitation. And our drought watch continues for New York City and Westchester. Normally our reservoir is 94%. Right now they're at 81% of capacity. And on the satellite view, well, you can see we've got a system working its way past our area. And so we are going to be still waiting to see a little bit of maybe some heavy thunderstorms storms now working their way through western New York. The jet stream band of air 20,000 feet above the Earth's surface right now. Big area of high pressure along the eastern seaboard. The jet stream well up to the north, and the moisture funneling in around this system. So what we're looking at is some very, very hot air, and it continues right on into Sunday. Tomorrow's temperatures near 100. Saturday, ditto, 100 or a little bit better. Sunday, a front moves through, and that knocks the temperatures down maybe a little bit, down into the low 90s, but not much of a break in sight. So our forecast for you for tonight, overnight lows low to mid 70s with maybe a shower or two, some pretty heavy thunderstorms, as we said, back through western New York. And we don't think they'll make their way in here, but in case they hold together, we may see a quick thunderstorm. Temperatures tomorrow morning in the mid-80s with haze and humidity. Boat and Beach report tomorrow, winds out of the southwest, 15 to 20 knots, water temperature 67 to 73 degrees. And as far as your 5 days ahead, it is one broken record, ladies and gentlemen. Hazy, hot, and humid through the period. Tomorrow's high 98. Saturday, heavy thunderstorms possible in the afternoon, 100 degrees. Cools off to 93 on Sunday. Monday and Tuesday, more of the same as well, with temperatures in the mid to upper 80s. Time now to salute the
Too hot to have a little competition out at Central Park, right?
This was the only time of the day to get it underway. It was late at night, and they actually did inline skating competition out at Central Park. And, it was still warm enough to work up a sweat, as we showed you. Even at like 9 o'clock at night, it was still 85 degrees. The heat index was still at 90, so you got to be careful just about any hour of the next couple of days. It's 82 degrees outside right now, relative humidity at 67%. And the barometer's rising at this point. Winds are southwestern at about 7 miles per hour. And this evening, that was about the only help we could get. You. There was a gusty wind out there at points. 92 degrees, the warmest number of the day. 71 degrees where we started earlier this morning. And it's 80 degrees north of town right now. 75 out toward the end of the island. 87 still at LaGuardia Airport. 76 on the Jersey shoreline. Satellite picture will show you there's some bright white clouds back off to the west. This is actually a large complex of thunderstorms that has gotten itself together over the Great Lakes and should pass west and die out before it gets here and go a little bit north of us. That's the game plan tonight. So if you hear a little lightning in northwestern fringe areas or see a little lightning in northwestern fringe areas and hear some thunder, that's exactly what's going on. We don't think it'll all cruise through here, but we're going to keep an eye on it for you even tonight anyway. Also tell you that tomorrow we're facing an even warmer day when the heat index will be well over 100 to 105, in some cases up toward 110. When you get this kind of extreme heat for prolonged periods, several hours if you're exposed to it, heat exhaustion is a real possibility or a real danger, so you know what to do outside tomorrow. You've been through this in summers in New York before. Make sure you've got plenty of water with you. If you're outdoors, dress in light, loose clothing, so you've got all that covered. But it's also a good time to check on elder neighbors, make sure they're okay in this kind of heat, and make sure your pets and animals are completely out of this kind of heat if possible. It's going to be a brutal day tomorrow, and that's going to carry on into Saturday. I'd also watch those, the air stagnation problem tomorrow is going to be pretty high. I bet you we're going to see some ozone or smog levels that are higher than normal in the city, and that's going to be rough to breathe when you're moving around out there tomorrow anyway. Best indoors if you can work it out. 76 degrees is the early morning temperature, 67 out toward the end of the island. Inland number 70 degrees. That's the start in the morning, and sunrise is at 5:36. There's plenty of sunshine. It's hazy, though, in the morning, and it's hazy just about all day. 100 degrees is the top number in Philadelphia, very close to us tomorrow. We think we'll top off at 98, but the following day it is likely we'll see 100 degrees, and even tomorrow in Newark, I think 100 degrees is likely. And toward the Oranges and toward Patterson, that's a possibility as well. Weekend getaway, we'd give you two perfect stars if they were two perfect days. We'll tell you that Saturday is very hot, humid, uncomfortable, and it's going to be a little difficult to be outside for a good part of the day. But a backdoor cold front comes through Saturday night, which should make Sunday a bit more bearable. So we're giving you about a star and a half for the weekend. 76 degrees, hazy, warm, and steamy tonight. AccuWeather says tomorrow it's difficult to take, so be careful out there. Again, 98 degrees, hazy sunshine, very hot, and the heat index will be well over 100, near 110 in many cases. Saturday, the actual temperature is 100 degrees, so again, the same warnings apply.
Wow.
Tough time.
Again, hot weekend forecast. In a second.
Summer's come.
An adorable new pair at the Bronx Zoo.
Barometer 30.00 and rising. Forecast today, hazy, hot, and humid. Nearly to 100 degrees today. We're calling for 97. The record is 100 degrees set back in 1954. And winds will be out of the southwest today at about 10 to 15 miles an hour. Tonight, partly cloudy, warm, and humid. 79 in the city. We'll be in the low 70s in the suburbs, so it's going to be a sticky night for sleeping. And your five-day forecast, hazy, hot, and humid. Chance of a late afternoon shower or thunderstorm tomorrow and a high up to 98. And that is, in fact, the record high
for this time of year. And Sunday, partly sunny, a chance of scattered showers. 92 degrees will be your high. 88 on Monday with partly sunny skies. Tuesday, 86 with a chance of showers. And Wednesday, partly sunny. Make it up to 86 degrees for the high temperature. So things are looking pretty steamy for this weekend, James. But it looks like by next week we'll get at least a little bit of relief. Back to
you. All right, Jules. You look like you're having fun with your friends.
I actually am, yes. I'm having a much better end to this morning than I had a beginning to the morning.
All right, so you don't have to...
Exclusive AccuWeather forecast is next.
Why buy an ordinary sofa when you can buy a Jennifer sofa bed and love seat for just $599.99? That's both pieces for under $600 in so many styles and fabrics. Jennifer Convertibles, America's largest sofa bed specialist.
Feeling lucky? Here's one number to keep in mind. Your lucky number for daily drawings in the New York State Lottery. It's Channel 7. Check your daily picks in the numbers game and win four every evening during Wheel of Fortune. Take five every Tuesday and Friday during Eyewitness News at 11. And Lotto every Wednesday and Saturday during Eyewitness News at 11. This could be your lucky day, so don't miss your lucky 7. Channel 7, your lottery station.
So, you think you gotta go to the gym to keep in shape? You may be getting more of a workout than you know. The perfect reason to be drinking Crystal Light. It's full of light, juicy flavor. Five little calories. No guilt, no sacrifice. So, whatever you're doing to keep in shape, keep doing it. New Tropical Passions from Crystal Light. Treat yourself right.
Yep, I'm off to your party. Yep, got the address and phone number. In my pocket!
Can't get to the number? No problem. Get back that line. Press star 69. Call return gets back the last call you received. No need to subscribe.
Could I have that address? Again?
Get back that line. Press star 69 from 9X. 75 cents per use plus cost of call.
ShopRite presents another Charmin story. Here, Muffin uses a regular roll of toilet paper, while Boomer uses new Charmin Double Roll. It's two rolls of softness in one. When Muffin's roll runs out, Boomer still has a whole extra roll ready to go because it has twice as many sheets. And it's softer, too. It's two rolls of softness in one. New Charmin and Charmin Ultra Double Roll. For variety and price, come to ShopRite and always save.
For a limited time only at Jennifer Convertibles, buy this sofa bed and love seat for $8.99 and get our quality Genopedic mattress set absolutely free. Choose from a queen, full, or twin size mattress and foundation at no additional cost at Jennifer Convertibles.
I'm really happy. Very happy.
Hey.
And Australian Shelley Taylor-Smith has good reason to be happy. She just beat the world's record for swimming around the island of Manhattan. And she couldn't have picked a better day for it. Shelley started her swim just after 2:30 this morning. In the end, she knocked a full 10 minutes off the old record of 5 hours and 54 minutes.
Wow. She had to hurry because she was going to be late for the subway.
That's right. Yeah.
She had
a couple of tokens in her pocket.
Forget it. Yeah. Had to hurry.
Well, she was in the right place, though. At least staying cool.
Yeah.
You want to be, you know, at the places that are going to be most advantageous for you today and tomorrow. Go see a movie. Get to a mall. Get to the beach if you can. Keep the air conditioning running. It's only going to last for a couple of days, so you really don't have to worry about that, you know, electric bill that's going to be coming. Here's how it looks at Jones Beach. It's already crowded there. Wow. Everybody today just said, dude, work? No way. Hit the beach, and it's really good weather for it. The wind has been out of the south.
And Clinton now admits the peacekeeping may be helpless. Many Republicans and some Democrats say it would be outrageous if the United States left those refugees there to die.
It is utterly disastrous for the future of democracy and the future of law and civilization to have all the major industrial democracies look pathetically weak and incompetent.
France is one of the only countries that's now saying it's time to send in more troops and firepower to teach the Serbs a lesson. Others want to lift the arms embargo so the Bosnians can defend themselves. But the White House says if that happens, Americans could end up risking their lives alone.
Unilaterally lifting the arms embargo in Bosnia is certainly the way to drive the UN out of Bosnia and to drive the U.S. into Bosnia.
If UN troops pull out, the United States has already committed at least 25,000 American soldiers to help. But both sides could fight to stop the UN from leaving. And running away from this problem could kill hundreds of people who came here to help stop the nightmare.
And here in Washington tonight, President Clinton and his advisors are working overtime trying to decide whether those UN troops should indeed leave or whether they need to send in more force instead. We are live in Washington. Andy Field, Channel 7 Eyewitness News.
Thanks, Andy. A sweltering summer day. How long is this heat going to last? Sam Champion with the exclusive weekend AccuWeather forecast. Also, the crowds look for a glimpse of Hugh Grant, and he's on the spot once again answering questions from Regis and Kathy Lee.
Plus, a diamond dispute between a big star and a famous jeweler. Sharon Stone's suit is settled. And a royal deal for Fergie, her new career, coming up next on Eyewitness News.
This summer, when it gets really hot, Dunkin' Donuts suggests you cool off with a cup of coffee. Iced coffee, that is. It's the coolest thing around. It's Dunkin' Donuts' world-famous coffee brewed from our premium beans and served ice cold. So if you want to chill out on a hot day, come to Dunkin' Donuts for a refreshing cup of our delicious iced coffee.
It's very cool.
First floor.
Does this come with a matching carry-on? Let me check.
Instead of going to a department store for luggage, go to the luggage experts. Innovation Luggage.
Yes, it does.
Does this one come in green?
I'll find out. It comes in green.
Ask him if it comes with wheels.
Huh?
With 34 locations and guaranteed low prices, why go anywhere else? Right now, enjoy great savings on Travel Pro, the first choice of air crews worldwide.
Eyewitness News.
This summer, the writer of E.T. brings the beloved classic, The Indian in the Cupboard, to life.
You are so real.
Yes. Are you?
You are invited to experience...
They're people. You can't use people.
One of the most magical motion pictures of the year.
You should not do magic. You do not understand.
The Indian in the Cupboard, rated PG. Now playing at theaters everywhere.
Hey, New York, looking for a great vacation? Come up here.
Up there?
No, up here to Connecticut.
Surprise! Connecticut!
There's so much to do!
Get away!
Call today for your free Connecticut vacation guide.
For information and reservations, call 1-800-CT-BOUND.
What do you like best about Pudgies?
It's delicious.
It's delightful.
It's delivered.
Get 13 pieces of chicken for only $9.99. Just call Pudgies.
No one wants to sit in traffic on a day like this. It puts a strain on your patience and your air conditioner. John Del Giorno is live at Metro Traffic Control with more on the evening rush. How's it look out there, John?
Greg, it's a miserable day if you're trying to make it out the Lincoln Tunnel. That's what we're looking at here over Weehawken, New Jersey, and look at all that volume. If you're trying to get out of the city, you've got a 30-minute wait, but this is what you've got waiting for you on the Jersey side.